मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स, दैट इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग सेक्युलरिज्म। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न फोर मेजर थिंग्स। फर्स्ट वन, व्हाट इज सेक्युलरिज्म। सेकंड, व्हाई इज इट इम्पॉर्टेंट टू सेपरेट रिलीजन फ्रॉम स्टेट। थर्ड इज, व्हाट इज इंडियन सेक्युलरिज्म एंड इट्स स्ट्रेटेजी। एंड लास्ट इज, डिफरेंस बिटवीन इंडियन सेक्युलरिज्म एंड सेक्युलरिज्म ऑफ अदर कंट्रीज। And in the previous chapter, the Indian Constitution, you have already learnt about the key features of the Constitution, and one of the key features was secularism. Now let me start with an example. You are a Hindu or Muslim, a US citizen living in USA, where Christianity is the major religion there, and suppose no one is willing to rent a house to you. How are you going to feel? Won't you feel resentful? So your feelings will be of two types: either retaliation, which means that you will also give them the same treat, you will say let us give them the same treatment to the Christians in places where Hindus and Muslims are in majority, or you might take another view and say there should be justice for all and nobody should be discriminated on the grounds of their religious practices and beliefs. Yes. So actually, this is the true essence of secularism. Let's go ahead and we'll see some countries which are non-secular. That means they have one official religion. Now, let us look into Hitler's Germany. What happens in Hitler's Germany? The Jews were discriminated. Yes, there was exclusion, there were persecution. That means they were ill-treated and harmed. And many of them were killed. Yes. And same thing happens in Israel, being a Jewish state. What happens? They treat their Muslims and Christians in minority and treat them very badly. Same thing happens in Saudi Arabia, where non-Muslims are not allowed to build temples, churches, or nor they can gather in public places for prayers. Now, in what happens in these above examples that I have given you? That one religious community is, which is in majority, is discriminates the members of the other religious community. So clearly, what do we see? That there is domination and discrimination because one religion has been given the official recognition by the country. Now, we say India is a secular country. What does that mean? Means that India does not have any official religion, it does not promote any religion, and every Indian citizen is free to follow any religion of his or her choice. All religions are given equal treatment, there is no discrimination, equal opportunities are given to in jobs and in the educational institutions, equal opportunities are given to all in religion. And India is neutral towards all religions. So aren't we very lucky to be in a secular state? Yes. And we have also been given the fundamental right to freedom of religion. Okay. So this is the real essence of secularism. Now in my next video, I will be dealing with the next point. That is, why is it important to separate religion from state?